Welcome back to Embedded Lab. So in this lab session, we are going to start the interfacing with ARM STM32F401XX. Okay, so for simulation purpose, we have used 401 RE series. Now, this interfacing can be done for any series as we are using the Nucleo boards. Okay. So first, the most important part in this is the configuring of our STM boards. Okay, so I'll do it by taking the simple program. And the first program what we are going to deal will be an LED interface and blinking of LED without any delay. Means continuously it will be switch on and switch off. Okay, so now unlike the other programs, we will be writing the program interfacing programs in C language, because it is easy. Okay, for that we have to download the two header files by the name called ash include STM32F4XX_HAL.h. This is a header file what we will be using for our interfacing purpose. Coming to the another header file, the header file which refers to the peripheral what we are going to use. The peripheral what we are using is our LED. So the header file what we will be using is the library function ash include board_LED.h, means this is the header file which is concerned with respect to the LEDs that are present on the board. Not these, if you want to connect the LEDs externally, then we have to write a separate code for it, and there won't be any header file like this hash include board_LED.h. Okay, so if you see the program, it's very, very simple program. Okay, so as usual, we'll be having a main program and a constant variable will be declared, unsigned integer num, which is declared as zero, and then LED initialize. So we'll be initializing the LED function, which is a part of the board_LED.h. So this will initialize the LED. Then we are using a while loop. Until this while loop is true, so till the while loop is true, the LEDs are going to on and LED is going to get off. So LED on, and we are passing the information by information num. Num is equal to zero. So on the num, off the num. So LED will be continuously keep on and keep on off. So let us have a simple demo of it and how we are going to connect it. Yeah. So this is the Nucleo board what we will be using for our interfacing purpose. STM32F401RE T6, and it is having 64 pins, and you can see the specifications on the Nucleo board chart. Okay, so it is having 512 KB flash memory, 96 KB static RAM, two extension connectors for Arduino and IN4, embedded UNIC V2 version debugger programmer, embedded enabled. So see here. So these are the specifications, and this is a program what we have seen. Okay, so see here, we are writing in C program and open the key C version, go for new project, select the new project, give some name like blinking LED, save it. Now here, so in the simulation, we will be using the legacy part, but here we'll be using the boards directly, so we have to go with the hardware section. So software packs we have to get select, and within that we have to select our Nucleo board STM32F401RET transmission section. So once we select it, we'll get an option. Okay, so what are the peripherals we are having and what are the peripherals we can use for our program? So for our program, we are using the peripheral called LED. So let us check where the LED is present. So once you select the nucleo board, so you have to select the nucleo board before that, nucleo board. Then go for the board support. In board support, you can find LEDs. So you check it. Then CMOS core, you have to check the C core, and then device. So you have to make use of the startup, and we have to make use of the classic model. Okay, so don't go for any other model, just select the classic model. And this is how we configure the nucleo boards. So once it is done, so in your target you can find the board support, devices, everything. So next, select the startup, select the devices, and so select the target, go for the device, update the RTE device, update the startup, then merge the, update the STM, update. So update all the devices. Later, go for the target and optimize it. So we have to give the frequency at which we are going to operate, clock frequency. So clock frequency will be given by 104 megahertz. And then the type of debugger what you are using will be ST-Link debugger. So that you have to select options for target. Then I'll come again. Yeah, once you select the debugger, go for the settings, flash download. You can download the flash. Okay, you can make it. Then go for the source group, optimize it, and create the C file. Okay, so the Blinkers C file, already we have written the text that we will be adding to our source group. So be careful that this program is completely based on case sensitive. So you have to be utmost care in writing the code. So once it is done, you save it and you build it. Okay, once you build, you get the, so you have to be make sure that it is free from errors and also warnings. So here we got a warning for the extra line. So delete that line. So once you delete the line, you will be getting zero errors, zero warnings. So once it is done, you have, once again for safety purpose, you rebuild it. And this is the board what we'll be using, and these are the LEDs which we try to glow it. Okay. So connect the device directly with the help of the USB port, micro USB port and normal USB port to the system, or if you have the laptop, then go for the debugging. So once it is done, okay, you will be having the program like this. So press, as usual, you go for the debugging process, F10. Yes. See, it is being on, off, on, off. So this LED is keep on glowing on, off, right? So this is a simple program for LED blinking. So in the next session, we'll be seeing the LED glowing with the help of some delay. Okay.